5 million Kenyan shilling to Soweto Catholic Church. 300,000 Kenyan shilling to buy uniform, Soweto Catholic Church. A bus for the church. That is just a tip of the iceberg, because a lot of money was poured today in Soweto Church in Nairobi. And this is William Samoei Ruto who gave this kind of, I don't know what to call them. I don't know whether to call them rewards or gift or what would one would call it. Is it even a tithe? Is it a tithe? Is it an offering? What is it, ladies and gentlemen? Maybe you can help me to explain here what is it all about. This is happening to the Catholic Church. And I repeat, Catholic Church. After the Catholic bishops raised an alarm, after the Catholic bishops started criticizing William Samoei Ruto about governance, poor governance, after these guys, the bishops, told William Samoei Ruto that abduction must come to an end. They told him that extrajudicial killing must come to an end. They also told him that he's lying so much. So, ladies and gentlemen, what is wrong if we say this is a bribe? If we say that he's trying to bribe the bishop, if he's trying to bribe the church, would we be wrong? What do you think? That's my take. And this is happening when we have so many schools which are running under trees, makeshift camps, schools, mad world schools, and you wonder who should come first. The house of a bishop worth 5 million and a bus and cash 300,000 to buy uniform for the church, or build schools. See how our priorities are upside down. See how our leaders are misusing our money. See how our leaders can do anything to remain relevant. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want us to look at this kind of donation and see what is meant to be achieved. The first question you should ask yourself: why did William Samoei Ruto choose to go to Catholic Church today, and why Soweto? Number one, it is the bishop of Catholic Church who actually started this conversation, and they were united, and I think I understand the same message was shared across the Catholic churches in the whole country. So he's trying to cool down the temperatures. He's trying to show them that he's part of the church. Number two, William Samoei Ruto is fearing 2027 general elections. He fears that if the church is going to oppose him openly like it is doing, then he's completely finished. He must also have learned a lesson yesterday in Embu. Yesterday, you remember what happened. Some people were even walking out after Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta finished his speech. I saw a number of people walking out, though the mainstream media will not show you this. William Samoei Ruto was heckled, was booed. Gachagua was welcomed like a king. William Samoei Ruto was almost carried shoulder high by the people. And William Samoei Ruto tested the political temperatures. And he realized that things are not good. And this is a church. This is happening in the church, by the way. The church is likely to lead the opposition against William Samoei Ruto. And if the trend continues, William Samoei Ruto knows that he cannot win the 2027 general election. Again, he's using this method because you see, how many bishops would refuse money? How many? No matter the source of the money, how many? Even if it's proceeds of corruption, they would take it. Even if it is money meant for the orphans, they would take it. Even if it's the money meant to educate the fathers and the mothers, they would still take it. So money ni mbomo wa mlima, pesa huvuja mlima. So William Samoei Ruto anataka kuvuja mlima wa kanisa akitumia hela gweje darahimu. That is what William Samoei Ruto is doing. Again, since this method worked for him in 2022, he want to repeat it. If it worked for him, then it can still work for him this time round. Remember, William Samoei Ruto entered Mount Kenya using the church. In fact, Like now in Kadara, Kadara constituency alone, where Alice Wahome was a member of parliament, William Samoei Ruto went more than 20 times, went to conduct her base, went to do so many things, including launching petrol stations when he was a deputy president. So he camped literally in the mountain, and he's trying to do it again through the church. Again, I also believe that he's trying to neutralize Gachagua because of what happened again in Embu. If you look at Gachagua, Gachagua was also today in Kajiado. And he was also welcomed by the people. People are very happy. So the church is just a stepping stone to 2027. If it's going to work for William Samoei Ruto, maybe only time will tell. I want you to watch what he was saying here in Soweto Church before we conclude this video. Watch here, guys.
Lakini kwa sababu nimefika hapa leo, nataka niungane na governor wetu, hawa watoto wa PMC na wale vijana wengine walikuwa hapo, wamefanya kazi mzuri. Na mimi naona wako na uniform mzuri. Sakaja amewapanga kiasi. Lakini, mimi nitawapangia uniform ingine mpya. Na kwa hivyo, kiongozi wa hapa, tajipanga. Ngojeni mambo yenu bado. So, hawa watoto, tawataftia shilingi 1,300 saizi, tununue, wanunulie uniform. Kuna mtu atapanga uniform ya hawa watoto, sio? Na nyinyi pia, ni wanunulie uniform ingine mpya. Ndiyo? Kabla sijatoka hapa. Sindiyo? Lakini, kazi yenu ni kumuimbia Mungu. Sio kuimbia binadamu. Kumuimbia nini?
Mungu.
Kumuimbia Mungu. Sawa. Alafu, nimeambiwa na huyu mtu chairman. Naitwa Isanda. Isanda. Ameniambia mnajenga nyumba ya father hapa. Sindiyo? Na mimi ni mtu ya kujenga. Najenga affordable housing, najenga ingine. Hiyo ni kazi yangu. Hiyo ya kujenga, mimi naelewa. Sawa. So, hiyo nyumba ya father, pale, wana Isanda. Sawa. Utakuja kuniona Monday ama Tuesday. Utakutafutia shilingi 1,500,000. Lakini, na hiyo pesa, nasikia mkubwa, hiyo pesa nitafuatilia. Ukipiga kona hivi kidogo, utakutana na mimi. Tumesikia mimi nilisema mambo ni matatu. Ujichunge. Sindio? Sawa sawa. Alafu, mambo yale mengine, nita panga panga. Kwa sababu niliambiwa pia, munataka bus. Sasa, hii mambo yote itawezekana siku moja. Hata nyinyi kwa mpango yenu. Wacha niende, unajua mimi ni mkulima, eh? So, sahi tunavuna ngano, tunavuna namna hii. Nikirudi Januari, nitarudi na basi yenu. Kukuja ndawaletea basi. Naona.